Hello and welcome back to part three of this tutorial on this very simple dress that we're making in a warm material. It's been made out from what I had left over pieces of fabric, and I want to design and show you that it's not actually the fabrics that go on to create the outfit. It's your imagination and how much of an effort you're going to put and what you're going to apply and how you're going to stitch it and really come up with the end result. What we are seeing nowadays is a lot of the outfits that are being sold are a combination of lots and lots and lots of different pieces which the designers are stitching and portraying as beautiful suits on images, and we're actually buying according to that image. And that's an image that we can create. If you put effort into it, then that's something that we can create ourselves. Something like this, a combination of two different velvets and some lace on a simple warm fabric. So what I've done is basically a tutorial on this, on a cutting of a churidar in a wide width fabric, and we're also, I cut the sleeves in plain fabric, and I'm just attaching the sleeves. I'm attaching these on the open. The only problem with fabrics, a lot of these type of fabrics, is that you do have to overlock this. This is a nice hard wearing fabric, which is quite warm and comfortable to wear. It has a reasonable fall, so it will suit the type of dress that I'm making. Now, one of the things that I wanted to talk about was, since wearing kalidars and kurtas and also dresses, A-line dresses and so on, in flowy fabrics, I've found it difficult to go back to wearing a traditional salwar kameez. A traditional salwar kameez is very standard, and it actually doesn't do anything for a figure. Especially winter fabrics, which are quite heavy and stiff and don't actually have a fall. So over this last couple of weeks, I've been trying to source out some fabrics which are, you know, adequate to do winter clothing in. And to be honest, I was a little bit disappointed. Now, I've had quite a few requests on velvet. I feel a little bit apprehensive about doing velvet because of the fact that for the last 3 years I've been quite heavily concentrating on velvet in the winter months. Last year we did a lot of merino designs, and for anyone who's, to be honest, the merino is one of the nicest of fabrics and has the most beautiful fall that I would recommend for winter. The colors are often quite dark colors, which are wintry colors. Now, recently I was reading an article on Facebook which Crescent Lawn had put on, and they were asking viewers and their clientele of what were the winter colors, what they thought were the winter colors, and a lot of people were actually pointing out to black. Now, I know black is quite a common color. We don't tend to often stick to colours like the one that I'm sewing. It's quite a pastel shade, and to be honest, it doesn't look very wintry. I prefer the darker colours for winter, just like normally the trends are. So navy blue, bottle green, maroon, deep red are all the colours that I would love to, dark brown. Or warm colours, like rusty colours, are quite nice to have. So we're going to hopefully try and source something out. But fabric-wise, it's very difficult to find. A lot of the time, what happens is fabrics like these type tend to have very heavy embroidery done on them. And when you have a heavy fabric and it has a heavy embroidery done on it as well, it tends to stiffen it out, and it just doesn't have the flow anymore. So I like the fabrics which have a beautiful flow, and that flow with the body. I'm just going to quickly overlock this because before we do the fitting seams. So you're going to see a slight pause in So let's get back to this point that I was trying to make on heavy fabrics, which are made even heavier when it has a thick, heavy embroidery done on it. Now, I prefer the plainer ones than to the heavy embroidered ones because they tend to have a beautiful fall. Now this is going to be a very simple dress, and the only highlight of this dress is going to be obviously the border lace trim. It's going to be closed off because it has a churidar. Now it's a little bit lengthy, so I may need to trim down the length a little bit. As you can see, it does fray a lot, so overlocking on garments like this is essential. Now, we've been attending classes. It's called Tarbiya Olad, which means upbringing of children. And it's been a brilliant course that the local imam at the mosque has been running. Now, I'm waiting for the finishing of the course when they will be hopefully uploading all the... Just when you need the thread, it runs out. They will be uploading the full lecture, and I have been taking recordings. Unfortunately, by the time I've done the recording, sometimes the speaker is too far and it doesn't record too well. And then we often have problems when we do the recordings. Playing it in the background of noise from the sewing machine doesn't actually work quite well. So I really want to share these videos with you because they are just so valuable, talks that I think all parents need to take all that information on board and really just follow it through because it applies to each and every one of us. Now, one of the things, beautiful things that he says and talks about is involvement. And last week's lecture, he was talking about that, you know, the best way to actually get your message across is to get the person you're trying to get the message to, get them involved. So there's three ways of teaching someone. The first two, they're most likely to forget, but if you get them involved, then the chances of that are quite heavy in remaining with them. And I thought that was such a beautiful thing to say because I know for a fact that anyone who's involved in sew-alongs or working along with me is going to get a lot of beneficial knowledge which they can actually apply. So what I'm hoping is that many of you will take the opportunity to actually work alongside me and share in on the tutorials so that the tutorials do benefit you and you do go on to learn something rather than just watching the videos. Sometimes you actually hurry along and rather than getting something done. Oh yes, my eyesight has gone really, really weak, and I did go for a checkup last week, and it has fallen. My eyesight has actually was 1.75 and now is gone to 2.5, so quite a big increase. That's why I struggle to sometimes thread the needle. Okay, so let's get back to hopefully finishing this dress. So yes, rather than watching and just dismissing the video, I would like to see more of you actually participating and sharing your comments and positive comments like, yes, I've tried this, I've tried to make this. If you've encountered problems, then by all means write down your problems, and sometimes other people will read your comment and address what problems you're having. Also, just getting a response to a comment is a positive encouragement, and often we can learn a lot from other members. One of the best encouragements is your fellow enthusiasts. So if you have a passion for sewing and you go onto the website or the channel and you share your comments and your viewpoints, sometimes the encouragement from fellow students or fellow followers will actually boost your morale in doing more. So, you know, do give feedback whenever possible, because feedback is a positive thing for me, and it's a positive thing for yourself if you actually do make comments. So that is the dress actually completed. I'm going to overlock this, turn this, press it before we come back and attach the trim, which I'm going to hopefully do the next part 4 of this tutorial on.